Previously on the teleporters.
I think it would be a once-in-a-lifetime experience for us to go to the Amazon and meet Carol Baskin-Robbins and her bears.
Shake, Smokey.
Good boy, Smokey. Do either of you boys want to give Smokey his treat?
Yeah, there we go. Okay. Here's your treat, Smokey.
Apple, yeah.
Ah!
Oh, no!
Ah! He's got my teleporter!
Hey, Spork?
Yes, Captain.
I think we're stuck in the Amazon.
I am one with the Amazon!
No! You're not!
Captain! Captain.
Yes, Spork?
What is the condition of the teleporter?
Oh, it's doing just fine. Never been better.
Excellent. Then we should be our way now, shouldn't we? Oh, that was sarcasm. I have trouble detecting it. But you promised you would never be sarcastic towards me again.
I know,
after the time you thanked me for stepping on your toe.
I know, I'm sorry, okay? Like, I'm sorry, Spork. I'm frustrated. I want to get out of here.
As do I, Captain. I have an idea.
And what's that?
Since we have lost function of the teleporter, we can send out a beacon to reach your ship and have it pick us up.
That's a great plan, Spork, except I don't have a ship.
You do not have a ship?
Not anymore.
But all space fleet captains are issued a spaceship to command.
Yeah, no, right. I meant, I don't have one anymore right now. It's in the shop for a torn rotator cuff. But when everything's working properly, she is something special. The USS Joshua 19.
Well, in that case, do I have your permission to apply the universal human technique of problem solving? I am very proud to have learned it.
Be my guest.
The method goes. You turn it off. Then turn it back on.
Spork, if you think that's gonna work, I don't even know what to do. It worked! Spork, you're a genius.
Thank you, Captain.
It's really quite very extremely cold here.
Yes, you are exceptionally correct. But where is here?
I don't know, my teleporter's telling me this is the Swiss Alps we're in, but I don't know, something feels a little off.
This terrain is highly uninhabitable. Like I said before, why are we here?
I don't know, buddy, but we're gonna find out. And we might just find out that way. Let's go. What's up, man? Why are you so slow? There's a castle. We're trekking towards a castle.
Do not travel too quickly, Captain. This frigid air will exhaust you, and I will be forced to carry you. I do not want to do that.
Please, Spork, hey, if anybody's gonna have to carry somebody, I'm gonna have to carry you at some point. Let's get out there.
Huh? Preposterous. Preposterous.
Amazing.
Fascinating.
Look at this place.
Very fascinating. Quite. This cannot be naturally formed. I am confused. Please explain, Captain, and if you will, uphold your vow of no sarcasm while you do so.
There's no sarcasm here, Spork. You're right. This ain't natural. It's funny, though, because this actually reminds me of...
Who are you? What are you doing in my castle?
I think the better question is, who are you?
I asked you first.
I asked you second.
Doesn't make any sense.
I know you are, but what am I?
Huh?
Princess with magic ice power, say what?
Who?
When?
Where?
Enough! If you must know, I am Princess Elsa of Arendelle.
She is Princess Elsa of the Disney film franchise Frozen.
It would seem so.
Then here we are. Also, in this fictional world of Arendelle.
Picked up on that.
What does this mean, Captain?
I think it means that Old Smokey did a little bit more damage on the teleporter than we realized. Let's roll with the punch. Not literally.
Oh, okay.
Hi! Nice to meet you, Princess Elsa. I am Captain Kurt, and this is Spork, and together, we are the Teleporters.
Oh, we're doing a thing.
I thought we would do a thing.
We're doing a thing.
I sent you an email.
Teleport, the
Three, two, the Teleporters.
The Teleporters.
Go on, go. Okay. Three, two, the Teleporters. I went on
there
one.
Was no
that
go.
Was on me. That was my fault. Three, two, one, go.
The Teleporters.
We'll work on it. And we're on a mission to prove to my good buddy here that God exists everywhere, even in the highest, coldest, and most fictional parts of the galaxy.
And as I am learning, I've found that it is also important to share the evidence we have found with other people and articulate the word of God wherever we go.
I see.
So, tell me, Princess, did God help you construct this miraculous castle?
No.
No?
I mean, I don't think so. I'm all alone here. I'm the queen of this kingdom of isolation.
Don't you mean isolation?
I apologize for the captain's poor sense of humor. Maybe we should laugh as to make him feel better about himself. Ha ha ha.
Thanks for the effort.
You're wasting your time. I'm alone here. I always have, I always will be, and that's just the way it is, and the way it should be. You should just leave.
Respectfully, Princess, I do still wish to know how all of this was built. If God did not help you, another person must have.
Nope. It was all me. I specifically remember singing an entire original solo song while putting it together.
But how?
I used my powers. My ice powers.
You don't understand.
Understand what?
Okay, so...
Maybe, as humans say, I should have a go at it. I've learned some. Let me try.
Take this one, buddy.
That is God.
That is ice.
No. I'm saying that the reason you are able to do what you do is because of God. Those gifts you have come from Him. He is the reason you have them. So even though you may have built the castle alone, God was helping you after all.
I didn't realize. I think I get it.
And the Bible talks about spiritual gifts, yeah? gifts that people are born with. God is showing himself through the powers he gave you.
Is that possible?
If he can create the entire universe, surely he can grant you power over ice.
See, Elsa, you're not alone. God is with you right now. He's in every block of ice that makes up this great castle.
You're right. I'm not alone. I've had him with me this whole time. But what do I do now that I know?
The next right thing.
Which is to use your powers to glorify the one that gave them to you.
But how do I do that?
You'll find a way.
I'm proud of you, buddy.
Mm-hmm.